In 60 seconds, it will be hard to convey how excited I am about this opportunity we have, a once-in-a-generation lifetime, to bring in a new generation of leadership that understands how deadly important national security is from someone who has been there and done that and seen the reality at the tip of the spear. A once-in-a-generation opportunity to not only unleash the innovative spark necessary to take Texas to the next level, but somebody who has been a part of that economy, growing and building jobs right here in the district. It's a once-in-a-generation opportunity to tackle issues like healthcare and taxes and immigration, not from a standpoint of rhetoric, not from a standpoint of grandstanding, but someone who's been in the arena, who's actually had to get it done at the end of the day, despite the rhetoric, despite the tone. And that's what I want to do in Washington, D.C., representing this district, is fix problems where I see them and represent you in a way that hasn't been done in decades.
Thank you, Joseph. Chip, your closing statement.
Sure, we do have the opportunity of a lifetime. We've got a growing consensus that we need to challenge the status quo in Washington, that we need to change things and take a different direction. And I think we're on the right path if we can come together to do that, unify as a country behind our core constitutional ideals, and make sure that we return power to the people and focus federal government where it should be on defending our nation, creating an environment for strong economic growth, and then getting out of the way. We didn't talk on one big issue, which is healthcare. And in this closing minute, I just want to say, if you want to right the ship for the United States of America, look no further than what we need to do to reclaim healthcare freedom for our family and for the next generation of Americans, so that we're not crippled by tripled insurance premiums under Obamacare. One third of American counties where you can only get access to one insurer, all because we've allowed the federal government to have too much influence on our healthcare system. And now we're heading potentially down the path of us a half step behind our friends in Europe. That just what we just witnessed with Alfie Evans, which is a human tragedy, and that is leaving life in the hands of bureaucrats and judges instead of the parents that love their child. That's not the direction to go. If you want to reclaim the United States of America, get control of our national debt, start with healthcare freedom, and make sure that we can grow our economy again, getting the burden of healthcare off the backs of our economy and the American people, that it's stifling their ability to perform. That's why I'm running for Congress. God bless y'all. Thank y'all for being here.
Thank you, Chip. Barry, your closing statement.
So, where I'm coming from is probably best described by my childhood. My parents and grandparents before them and great-grandparents before them were farmers in rural southern Missouri. My parents grew up on a farm in one of the poorest places in the country during the Depression. And they came to the St. Louis area, met each other, got married, raised five kids on working class incomes. My father was a machinist, McDonnell Douglas, building aircrafts and Mercury and Gemini space capsules. My mom worked at a local junior high as a secretary. We lived paycheck to paycheck. And so what I know from that experience is there are people who work hard every single day of their lives, all day long, and never have a dime to show for it. But the work itself and in their own integrity is what they are proud of, not the money. And so where I come from, all of this is a place of what opportunities did I get because my parents and grandparents and great-grandparents before them were hard workers. I had opportunities that they didn't have because I had a good education. I start and begin with good education because it is a pathway out of systemic poverty. The life I have now is far better than the life my parents ever imagined that they could provide. I want that for my children and grandchildren, but if we don't have a good education system, that is not going to be possible. I want to represent this district, and I want to represent this district because I want to let everybody know that I hear, listen to, and respond to those who are on the bottom rung, and if we can't lift them up, then none of us are going to excel. And we need to start at the very bottom and give people hopes and dreams for their future, just like I have.
Thank you, Mary. For our final closing statement.
Thank you again, all of you, for coming, and those of you who are viewing on Facebook Live, we certainly appreciate it. And I am Matt McCall, and I'm running for Congress because I have two kids, and they're real kids like your real kids. And our country is indeed in crisis, and it's a crisis of leadership. And I want to go to Washington and fight for our Constitution and our values to get our federal government under control. There's one concept behind the Constitution, and that is that all men and women women, are evil, and none should be trusted with power. And that's why we have separations of power. And I believe, as my parents taught me, and no doubt yours did, that good morals are corrupted by bad company. So I want to go and fight for our values for 6 years and go home. And I think that you can make a difference when you take your skill set of running a business and being in the business world for 30 years, of traveling around the world, and go and fight for those values and get us back to our Constitution and freedom and opportunity and growth. So we are, again, the land of the free and the home of the brave, and not the land of the safe and the home of the equal. Again, Matt McCall, and please, everybody, both parties, go out and vote in the May 22nd runoff. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Matt, and thank you to all four candidates for being here today and taking our questions. And I believe Dana Harris, the Austin Chamber.